these things, just like, as I said before, what he knew and his attitudes from 100 years ago were very different from they are today. Over the last 100 years, attitudes about Howard Carter have changed. At the time, when I was young, when I was your age, which was a long time ago, I remember reading books as a youngster about Howard Carter and King Tut's tomb, and he was always portrayed as a very heroic, wonderful archaeologist, and he was. He was a very impressive archaeologist. He was very careful, very methodical. He took a great care in excavating that tomb, labeling everything, photographing everything before he moved, to taking great care to conserve these objects before they were moved so they wouldn't fall apart. Some of the techniques they used were common then or were invented then for those objects, are not maybe what we would do today, but that's because we've progressed technologically in how you would preserve certain things. But his basic approach of being very careful was an excellent one. It was not typical for his time in the 1920s. Many archaeologists, the one who was digging in the Valley of the Kings before Howard Carter and Lord Carnarvon, a man named Theodore Davis, who owned the or controlled the concession for the Valley of the Kings in the early part of the 20th century, before World War I, he excavated some very important tombs in the Valley of the Kings, about which today we know almost nothing, because almost no photographs were taken, no record was made of the objects that were taken out, or anything. Again, he was a product of his time, but he was far less careful than Howard Carter was.